found a way, attacking the goal to our right. And this, the 20th meeting in European competition of a side from England and Scotland. The Scots have only won on 4 occasions, and you have to go back 12 years to the last time when Celtic beat Leeds United in the semi-final of the European Cup. Here's Gordon Strachan. Strachan, who missed so much of last season with a stomach muscle injury. Steve McCall to Arnold Muren, who, like French Tyson, has started the season in fine form. Ipswich skipper, Mickey Mills. It's a little bit long. Giving the back pass from Doug Rugby, and the goalkeeper is Jim Leighton, now rated as the third choice goalkeeper in the Scottish World Cup squad. Forward for Mark McGee between the two Ipswich defenders, and good pace by McGee, and sets up Hewitt, and in came Watson, and he was denied, but improvisation then by Paul Cooper, who came out and saved the shot with his right foot. But all that really the result of the pace of Mark McGee. 10 minutes gone and a few problems here for Ipswich. Two defenders in against one attacker, but the one attacker was too quick. McLeish has come up, Rugby is up, and helped himself to get up, in fact. Some real pace here by McGee, got away from Butcher well, took his moments, looked to see what was coming inside. Hewitt shot saved by Cooper, and Watson just denied getting the rebound. Tyson. Haven't seen too much of French Tyson yet, and that's true of the entire Ipswich midfield. For example, when have we seen John Wall? Out. And there's an often we go halfway through the first half of a match and John Walk really hasn't got into it yet. You see a few scarves then, red and white, as the ball went past. They certainly must be very pleased with the way that Aberdeen have started the match. Strachan. Miller. Muren. With McLeish behind him. This is McCall. Tyson far side. So is John Walk. Mills behind. Four in the middle. One of them is John Walk. Beaten to it by McLeish. Here's Muren. Kevin O'Gallagher waited for it to come down, but couldn't find the accuracy. But the first time really when Aberdeen was struggling, and Cooper was certainly ball watching. Look at the fair-haired player in the middle there. Really has lost his geography completely, and it was he that the rest of the Aberdeen players complained at after the shot went wide. McCall. at least there is a problem for him. It's nice from the court of Brazil, and even better from Brazil. And here's Gates, and the first time that Jim Leighton has had to save his charge. And a nice attack, really made by the fine crossfield ball by Steve McCall. And then the good control by Brazil on receiving it. The cross met by Gates, and the ball smothered by Leighton. Cross, good save that by Cooper, because Weir was coming in. It needed the touch from the goalkeeper in the last minute of the first half. Muren, a sweep for Tyson. Good turn, and a second one, and a third one, and it's going in. Yes, it went in. And the goal coming on the stroke of half-time. The shot parried by Jim Leighton. But really a marvellous piece of play by French Tyson. A lovely turn back that lost Watson once, lost him a second time. Then round the challenge of Rugby, and the left-foot shot that the goalkeeper parried, and McLeish just couldn't keep it out. The goal is a bonus for Ipswich, is the understatement of the season to date, because really they never put their game together during the first half, but they end it leading by the only goal, thanks to a moment of inspiration by Frans Tyson, their Dutch footballer of the year. Jim Leighton, who really had very little to do in that half, comes off looking a very dejected man. I wonder whether the Aberdeen supporters can quite believe it. Ipswich's home record in Europe really is a formidable one, playing tonight their 24th match, and up to now 21 wins and 2 draws. But Aberdeen certainly will feel very hard done by to be down at half-time in this match. Skipper, Mick Mills, no 2 trophies for them, the FA Cup and the UEFA Cup, and so dearly wants to hold the League Championship trophy. And it was half a look from Osman. Cooper, whose best save was probably made with his right foot. Dyson to change the atmosphere at Portland Road. Walk. McCall. Play by Steve McCall. Coming and trying a shot on his right. Five minutes of the second half gone, and Strachan not looking too happy then. Cooper, Kennedy, McGee, that's the corner. big men in the side. There's one going through, Neil Cooper, and another coming up, Alec McLeish. Both of them 6 foot one, and both taking positions on the far side, leaving Hewitt and McGee to take the near post. Rugby is up as well, and he's 6 foot two and a half, number three. McLeish got half there, and it's turned in by Hewitt. And there were six Ipswich players around the six-yard box, and no wonder Jim Leighton is delighted, because he must blame himself for the goal that he conceded on the stroke of half-time. But look at the height here, McLeish and Rugby together, and Hewitt turning on it as Cooper came out. And obviously, full of enthusiasm, and thinking in terms, no doubt, of the second leg at Bethodry in 2 weeks' time. Taken by Kevin O'Callaghan. Dates. O'Callaghan a little bit unlucky at the end, although maybe he had a bit of luck with the run of the ball initially. Brazil, who fed it to him, seemed to have lost it then, got it back then, but his stumble as he turned away from his man was too much. Defensive chalk. Gates, in goes Walk, came off Cooper. Brazil. And the goalkeeper had to adjust his position and made a brilliant save. Really did do well then, Jim Leighton. That makes up for the earlier error. But he had to adjust his position an awful lot. And he moved his feet well across and then got down very smartly indeed.